Hello and welcome to my first Let's Play Pokemon Trading Card Game Online video. My name is Matthias and today I'm gonna play with my currently favorite deck, which is a Lycanroc Zoroark GX deck. I think it's very versatile. Obviously it's very high in the current meta as well. Zoroark with amazing trade ability, acts as a great draw supporter, giving you access to a lot of your cards into your deck while discarding and thinning out your deck with cards which you might not need. In addition to that, Lycanroc has a Bloodthirsty Ice ability, which acts as a Lysander, so allows you to draw Pokemon from the bench. And I found in a lot of the matches, I played about 50 matches with this deck online, that it helps me out of a lot of tough spots. So let's dig into the versus ladder and try it out. All right, here's the deck. Let's see who we get as an opponent today. Okay, we see a Psychic Fairy deck. So Fairy, this might be a Gardevoir deck. Let's see. Elite Four Petro XD is calling the coin flip. I don't know if you guys noticed that sometimes your opponents are very slow in the beginning, but Petro did it, and obviously we want to start first. So let's see what we get. Sometimes the problem with the deck is you don't get a basic Pokemon on the first turn, but in this case we are lucky. We have the Zoroark out here, so we're gonna bring that out. My opponent is starting and we are ready to go. Not ideal to have immediate puzzle of time in hand. So he's playing the Zoroark 2 and we will need to probably dig for the Bridget. So we're gonna Ultra Ball here, get rid of those two puzzle of times, and find our Tapu Lele. The Tapu Lele then allows us obviously to find the Bridget. Okay, so let's see here. So we're gonna get the Bridget, but just going through, we have one Gasma only. That's a little bit concerning. Three and two Kukui there. We have plenty of Zoroarks, we have all four. We have three Rockruffs, two Lycanrocks, that's good. And let's see, energy-wise, we are pretty good with energy. So the Gasma is really only a little bit annoying. So let's do this, get the Bridget. I mean, we have one Gasma here in hand, so that's good. Didn't notice that. Let's get the Bridget out. And since our opponent also plays Zoroark, we definitely want to get some Rockruffs started. Maybe two and one more Zoroark. Obviously, Zoroark is weak against fighting, so if we get the Lycanroc out soon, we will be in a good position. And let's attach a Choice Band here. This might draw out also any Field Blowers which you have early. Okay, so this is good, and let's go forward with that. Let me know in the comments what decks you want to see, if you want to see more games with this type of deck, other decks in the meta or non-meta decks. I'm obviously just starting with recording trading card game videos. Would be cool to see what you guys want. Also, we have obviously Ultra Prism coming out very soon, so there will be deck opening videos and more videos with a new Ultra Prism card, especially strong new metal Pokemons. Okay, so we see here Wimpod, so Golisopod is in the play. That's, on the other hand, obviously concerning for our strategy to play Lycanroc. That's fine. So let's get the Zoroark out. We don't have any energy in hand, but hopefully we can fix that. Let's get a Choice Band on this friend. And let's do a trade. We don't need Bridgets anymore, so we can easily get rid of this one. Two Ultra Balls, we can make use of those. We can definitely use the N, so let's find, I would say, use this Ultra Ball and this Puzzle of Time. Let's find us a Lycanroc GX. And we're gonna evolve the Rockruff here. And let's bring out the Wimpod. That if we can get rid of the Wimpod early, that certainly can distract our opponent. We can also bring out the Tapu Lele. Should we do N? He has only three cards, so I would feel more comfortable with the Sycamore, even so that means we are discarding two good cards here. But I don't want to get him more cards, and this is obviously awesome. So now we are in a really good position. Get the Zoroark out here, get the bench full, so we have full hitting power with Riotous Beating. It's awesome. We have the DCE, and we can even draw another card if we wanted to. But for now, I'm pretty good, so I'm just going with the Riotous Beating and get the Wimpod out of the way. All right, let's see what we get here. And another DCE. So I think now we have all the DCE backs which we needed. So he goes with evolution, has a trade ability. So we saw his hand wasn't particularly strong. He had the Goliath support in hand, but obviously since we kicked him out, he couldn't use the evolution. He seems to be a little bit stuck. He has a Sycamore. So he's gonna get seven new cards. Discards a lot of energy. I'm surprised he didn't attach the DCE here. Has another DCE. It seemed a little bit of a waste for DCE. And obviously he won't have a lot of attack power with only one Wimpod on the bench. In the meantime, what I probably want to do is fire up another Pokemon. Probably want to fire up another Zoroark, in this case, given Lycanroc's weakness to grass. He plays one Puzzle of Time, or two. Let's see here. Was it one or two? I never can tell. Now we see if he gets two cards. He played, yeah. So he brings the Goliath support back with the Puzzle of Time. He can't evolve yet, since he brought the Wimpod out on this turn. So Riot is beating 470. That's okay. Rescue Stretcher, did we? We had the Tapu Lele. Don't need it right now. So that's certainly not something we need. He doesn't have a lot of bench Pokemon, so the GX attack here from Lycanroc wouldn't help us. I think what would help us is if we just do a trade. And in this case, I think I can get rid of one of the fighting energies. And we get a Field Blower, which is obviously good. Get rid of his Choice Band. Okay. And I want to bring out the last Zoroark, so let's do another trade. In this case, maybe for the Float Stone. Let's see what else we get. Okay. And now we can use the Ultra Ball. We're gonna get rid of the Rescue Stretcher and the Bridget and find us maybe the Full Art Zoroark here. Perfect. Get that out. And you see here, with the Zoroarks in play, you very quickly get access to your deck. It's pretty amazing. And let's get this set up as our backup attacker and go for the Riotous Beating with a full bench. 150 damage. Okay, great. Not sure. I don't think we discarded Acerola yet. Acerola might come in handy to pick up Zoroark. He will probably evolve the Wimpod, use the standing ability, which is what, 30 plus 90, 120, 100, he gets to 190. if he doesn't find a choice band. Okay, let's see what he does. If he finds a choice band, we get knocked out. If not, it would be good to get Acer Roller on the next turn to pick up this Zorak and attack with the next one. Okay. So we use the Ultra Ball, get a Tapu Lele, and then I assume a Sycamore or an N. Probably Sycamore. Let's see what I have. An Acer Roller. I'm not sure if I would do that with the few cards he has on hand. Maybe not the best move, but okay. Okay, hits for the first impression, and now we will need to retreat, or ideally Acer Roller. And the Acer Roller in the top deck, I mean, couldn't be better, obviously. So let's use that. Get the Zorak out of the way. Bring this one back. Attack the choice band. Bring the Zora. So we can do 120, 150. But not much more. So we won't be able to hit the Golisopod yet. But we can get this Zora loaded at least. Do we want to do any trades? I don't want to get rid of too many energies. So at this point in time, I'm actually fine. And I'm just continue with Rider Speeding to put pressure on the opponent. Alright, let's see what he can come up with. Okay, he gets his Zorak back. He can do trade. Okay, so he will be able to come up with a Crossing Cut GX. Which is a good attack. We might be able to come back with a Gazma. Okay. So 150 damage. And he brings out the Tapu Koko. Again, a perfect top deck. I mean, this time it goes fairly smooth. We're just gonna get Gazma out here. And we bring out our other Zorak. We're gonna evolve the third one. And I think at this point in time, I'm feeling comfortable to do a trade, get rid of one of the strong energy here. Nothing too interesting. I think we can do another trade for this Zorua. We have three Zorak in play, so don't need this guy anymore. An N and the Professor Kukui, that will be good. So let's keep that for now and go with a Rider Speeding for the knockout. Okay. I mean, really good luck with the top decks in this game. That certainly helps. Okay, so he brings back the Tapu Koko for the free retreat. If he had, let's see how many DCEs he already used. Two DCEs so far. Probably at place four. He has a Mewtwo, which won't be a problem for us. So he finds another DCE, so that's the third one. And a choice band and a Tapu Lele. Okay. Might be able to Gazma the Tapu Lele and with a. Okay. So he brings out another Gazma. Surprised he doesn't bring out Thor supporters in these situations with a very small hand. Okay, so he wants to go for the knockout. All right, so it's gonna go down to four prize cards, and we gonna come back with a Zorak. Okay, so we have the enhanced hammer. Perfect. So here is his third DCE, so here's only one DCE left. We have the Tapu Lele in hand. Do we need anything? Probably want to go for maybe go for a Kukui. See what other two cards we can get here. The Mallow will come in handy eventually. We're gonna go do a trade here for Rockruff. We need to look at, obviously, our deck. We don't want to deck out by accident, which I have seen even professional players on stream getting into the trouble. So we don't want to be in that trouble. So let's just use a Field Blower. Get rid of the... And maybe attach one energy to our Lycanroc. That should be it. Can bring out the Tapu-Lele to do a little bit more. What do we? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times is 100. Yeah, it's probably we should bring out this just to hit for the full bench. And I don't need really a supporter card, so I'm gonna say no. Gonna go for Riot is speeding for the 140. Right, we played the Professor Kukui, so that gave us an additional 20 damage. Alright, let's see what he can do. So he has an enhanced hammer in hand too, but we have another Zorak in play with a DCE, and we can also get the Lycanroc up and running. He's down to 13. We have 3 prize cards. Let's see what we can do. Ideally, I want to get the Zorak out of the way. We have the Gasma. Okay, so this is perfect. What we're gonna do is we're gonna Lycanroc. We're gonna switch the opponent. Bring out, let's say, his Tapu Koko, and then we're gonna switch ourselves again with the Gasma, get out the Zorak, which actually has a DCE. First, we need to choose, okay, bring out the wounded Zorak, so to speak, bring out our Zorak, attach another one here, and what we can do at this point in time. We can... No. Do I want to do another trade? No. I really don't want to. Just want to do a Riot of Speeding at this point in time. So 120. Okay. So one prize card left. Which should be fairly easy for us to get. Okay. Another Enhanced Hammer. What does he go for? The DCE? Yeah. Okay. What's the Gasma situation? Let's see here. So 1, 2. Should be another one in the deck. Which we might be able to get out using trade. Let's see. The upgrades to Glycopod. And then we'll be able to do a first impression on us. Okay. N down to 1. Not ideal, but again, we have 2 Zoroarks in play, so that should be fine. Let's see here. And we have only 1 DCE left. Okay. So ideally we can knock something out with a Lycanroc. And we haven't used our GX attack yet, so this is awesome. Just need to get that thing out. Okay, now I'm confused. He didn't bring out the Glycopod. A little bit confusing. So let's do some trades to see if we can get a Guzma, which would pretty much give us a game. Here's a Choice Band. Okay, there is a Sycamore. Trade down to 8. We could still play Sycamore. But then we can't play. I sometimes make the mistake of not considering those options. So, what I would do at this point in time is. How do we get this guy out? Where is a Guzma? Let's just wait. Let's just attach One fighting energy here and wait out the situation. Okay. If he knocks the Zorak out, he gets two prize cards, which is fine. We bring the Lycanroc and we win the game. At this point in time, with Dangerous Rogue, 4 on the bench, 200, we can do 240 damage given we have two strong energies. So let's see what happens. Is he bringing out the Goliath support? That's the question here. Okay. There's a Goliath support loaded. Another N. Mellow. Not bad. With that, we can search out an energy. Hopefully, there is one left. Okay, let's see if that works. What we're gonna do is we're gonna play the Mellow, which allows us to put two cards on the top deck. Okay, here is the last DCE. That's awesome. And is there a Gazma? Can't play it anywhere. Oh yeah, also Gazma is actually not even here. So we're just gonna use, let's say, Choice Band, but it's pretty much game, if I'm not mistaken. So we're gonna do trade. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna attach here. Riders Beating wouldn't be sufficient to hit the Tapulele, even with the Choice Band, we only 120, 150. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna retreat, bring out our friend Lycanroc. Attach a Choice Band for good measure and hit for Dangerous Rogue for the knockout in the game. Great. So thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you want to see more games, please let me know in the comment and like the video if you enjoyed the gameplay. I hope to see you soon. Have a great day.